Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Parshala. I am Dr. Saroj Yadav, Assistant Professor in Department of Education, University of Allahabad. Today we will discuss about the principles of curriculum construction at elementary level. The purpose of this module is to give the knowledge and understanding of the importance of curriculum construction for the students of elementary level. To give knowledge and understanding of the different principles of curriculum construction for the students of elementary level. Dear students, as we know that main purpose of the education is to provide such experiences which fulfill the individual needs and would enable a child to live socially useful life. Education should help to develop a child's potential so that he may be able to contribute to the society. A good and well-planned curriculum provides all the experiences to the child which are helpful for his all-round development. For a curriculum to achieve these objectives, it must be relevant to the child's need at different stages of life. It should provide suitable learning experiences for children of different capacities, abilities, aptitude, intelligence, and socio-economic status. There should be some variation and fluency in the content and learning experiences for the children who come from different background. Dear students, first of all, we will see about the curriculum construction. Curriculum construction is a planned, purposeful, progressive and systematic process for creating positive improvement in the educational system. As we know that at each moment there are changes and developments happening around the world. So the school curricula are affected. There is a need to update them in order to address the needs of the society. Now let's look upon the importance of curriculum construction. Curriculum construction has a broad scope because it is not only about the school, the learners and the teachers. It is also about the development of a society in general. In today's knowledge economy, curriculum development plays a significant role in the improvement of economy of a country. It also provides solutions to the world's conditions and problems such as environment, politics, socio-economic status, etc. Besides this, other issues on poverty, climate change and sustainable development are also considered during the curriculum construction. There must be a chain of developmental process to develop a society. Primary school curriculum must be developed to preserve the country's national identity and to ensure its economy's growth and stability. To have a better understanding of curriculum, let us go through some of the important definitions of curriculum. According to Kerr, all the learning which is planned and guided by the school, whether it is carried on it groups or individually inside or outside of school. Breslavsky states that curriculum is an agreement among communities, educational professionals and the state on what learners should take on during specific period of their lives. Furthermore, the curriculum defines why, what, when, where, how and with whom to learn. Outlines the skills, performances, attitudes and values pupils are expected to learn from schooling. It includes statements of desired pupil outcomes, descriptions of materials and the planned sequences that will be used to help pupils attain the outcomes. The total learning experiences provided by a school. It includes the contents of courses, that is the syllabus, the methods employed, and the other aspects like norms and values which relate to the ways the school is organized. Next is the aggregate of courses of study given in a learning environment. The courses are arranged in a sequence to make learning a subject easier. In schools, a curriculum spans several grades. Curriculum can refer to an entire program provided by a classroom, school, district, state, or country. A classroom is assigned sections of the curriculum as defined by the school. Courts define this curriculum as the massive, ongoing, informal curriculum of family, peer groups, neighborhoods, churches, organizations, occupations, mass media, and other socializing forces that educate all of us throughout our lives. With the help of this definition, we have come to know that curriculum is not only the syllabus or content, but it includes all the activities run in the school building, classrooms, laboratories, playgrounds, library, etc. Now, let us see the different types of curriculum now. First is child-centered curriculum. Child is given emphasis in the entire teaching learning process. Child-centered curriculum means children take command of their own learning. Teachers are there to provide support and facilitate the child's learning, but children determine the direction of their own learning, following their natural curiosities, interest, and passions. Child has the facility to choose the subjects according to his choice. All-round development of child is the aim of this type of curriculum. Second is subject-centered curriculum. In this system, the main focus is on curriculum development, but not on the human development. With subject specialist developing high standards for student uniformity, what our society believes all students should know and be able to do at grade level checkpoints. Teachers are told what and how to teach. The main goal and purpose is to standardize students to make them alike with a core curriculum. A large amount of meaningless testing is imposed on teachers to inflict on students. Teachers have big classes that restrict teachers from getting to know each child well enough to form a close relationship. Parents are usually not involved, expected to help their children with the teacher assigned homework. Teachers spend much time imparting the state curriculum. They focus on what students don't know and can't do. Students are required to do teacher assigned homework. Child is not getting emphasis in subject centered curriculum. Third is core curriculum, in which shortcomings of child centered as well as subject centered curriculum has been overcome. The core curriculum is the set of common courses required of all undergraduates and considered the necessary general education for students, irrespective of their choice in major. In core curriculum, some subjects are essential and some are optional subjects. So, it is useful for child as well as for the society. Next is spiral curriculum, which is a course of study in which students will see the same topics throughout their school career, with each encounter increasing a complexity and reinforcing previous learning. All of us know that curriculum plays very important role in the process of obtaining educational objectives. All the activities of any school are controlled by the curriculum. Teaching learning process is governed according to the objectives of school curriculum. Curriculum is the medium for the transfer of knowledge and experience to the next generation. Development of a child depends upon the curriculum. Curriculum construction is a plan of structuring the environment to coordinate the elements of time, space, materials, equipments, persons, etc. Steps of curriculum construction contains the cycle of analysis, design, implementation, evaluation, etc. There are some of the principles which should be followed during the curriculum construction. First principle is inculcation of play and activities. During the development of curriculum for primary level students, principle of interrelatedness of play and work activities must be emphasized. Child gains knowledge and learn easier by playway method. Learning activities and experiences should be made very interesting. So, curriculum should be activity centered and there should be interrelation between play and activities. Next principle is inclusion of all life activities. As we know that aim of education is the all-round development of child. Complete development of individuality is essential. So, all the activities and content should be included in the curriculum, which promote physical, mental, moral, social and political development of a child. Next principle is child-centered education. Curriculum should be according to the special needs of students. Students' need, interest, age, capacities, abilities and intelligence should be kept in full view, and close attention should be given during the curriculum construction. Elementary level students must have understanding of language, arithmetic, social sciences, work experiences, etc., which can fulfill social needs along with the individual development. Next principle is principle of continuity. As we know that it is the age of information technology. Knowledge and technology are changing very fast. New content knowledge is arising in this modern era. So, changes and continuity are desirable during the curriculum construction. Next principle is totality of experiences. Students should get the totality of experiences according to their age, needs, abilities. The integrated whole of human experiences should be included in the curriculum. Curriculum should include some total of various human experiences which a child receives in the school campus, classrooms, playground, library and laboratories along with academic subjects. Students also get experiences by various informal contacts with teachers. According to Secondary Education Commission report, curriculum does not mean only the academic subjects, but it includes the totality of experiences. Now, next principle is relation with life. Only those subjects and activities should be included in curriculum which is directly related with students' life. A student will take interest in studying those topics and doing those activities which are important for his life. Next principle is development of creativity and constructive powers. Different types of learning activities should be included in the curriculum, which are helpful in the development of creativity and constructive powers. Emphasis should be given on those subjects which provides the learning experiences essential for the development of creative abilities and constructive powers. Next is principle of social needs. Curriculum construction should be according to the ideals, needs and circumstances of the society. It should be developed in accordance with the accepted goals and ideals of the society. Curriculum should help the students to make able to solve the social problems so that the society can be developed. Curriculum should assist to develop the social values among students. Next principle is variety and flexibility. Curriculum should fulfill the individual capacities, powers and needs. It should be dynamic and flexible. There are individual differences among the children. They have different interests, aptitude, capacities, abilities and socio-economic status. Due to these differences, there must be enough flexibility and elasticity in the curriculum to suit these varieties. Variety of subjects and activities should be included in the curriculum to break the monotony. Next is the principle of balancing. There should be realistic balance between the objective with the content, students' abilities and learning experiences. Content should be updated, accurate and adequate. Children's abilities should be matched with the objectives to be attained. Suitable learning experiences must be designed to get the desirable objectives. Next is the principle of knowledge of culture and civilization. One of the major aims of education is the preservation, transmission and development of culture. There must be subjects, activities and experiences in the curriculum which provides the knowledge and understanding of their culture, values and civilization. So, the knowledge of culture and civilization is essential for the students or primary students. Principle of coherence. As we know that children's learning activities should be combined to form a coherent experience. There should be clear links between the different aspects of children's learning, including opportunities for extended activities which draw different strands of learning together. Next is the achievement of wholesome behavior pattern. According to Herbert Spencer, the prime aim of education is to achieve complete development of individuality. So, all the activities and subjects should be included in the curriculum, which inculcate physical, mental, spiritual, moral, emotional and political development of children. Various subjects, activities and experiences should promote the social and moral qualities which are essential for the development of wholesome behavior pattern of the child. Next is the principle of forward look. In the curriculum of elementary level, not only those subjects and topics should be included which are useful for daily life and fulfill the needs of the present, but curriculum subjects and materials should be forward looking, which enables the child to solve the various problems coming before him in the future. Curriculums should help the students to find out suitable solutions of the problems and achieve harmonious adjustment with the changing conditions and life situations. According to Crow and Crow, the curriculum should be so framed that it may help the children in the achievement of wholesome behavior pattern. Next is the principle of psychological sequence. Contents and activities of curriculum should be psychologically sequenced. In psychological sequence, emphasis is given on the interest, abilities, capabilities of the students, whereas in logical sequence, contents are given in logical order. In psychological order, students can learn the content very easily and they get the knowledge and understanding according to their mental status. Next is the principle of personalization and choice. The curriculum of primary standard should respond to individual needs, support particular aptitudes and talents. As we know that every child should be given increasing opportunities for exercising responsible personal choice. Once they have achieved suitable levels of attainment across a wide range of areas of learning, the choice should become as open as possible. It should be ensured that choices are soundly based and lead to successful outcome. Next is the principle of social ideals. Curriculum construction should be in accordance with the social ideals, goals, and conditions of the society. Curriculum plays very significant role for the development of social feelings according to the needs and conditions of the society. Curriculum should help to enhance the capacity to solve the social problems among students. Next is the principle of use of leisure time. It is the famous quotation that an empty mind is the devil's workshop. Generally, we see that students lose their leisure time in undesirable activities. It may create indisciplinary behavior among them. So, there should be such activities which are helpful for enhancing their hobbies. They can get pleasure in doing these activities during the leisure time. Their innate capacities and talents will also be developed. Next is the principle of correlation. Nowadays, we are giving emphasis on the interdisciplinary approach in every field of education. Curriculum should correlate among the subjects according to the needs of the students, nation, and society. Different subjects should be correlated according to their specific nature. Unrelated fragments and unconnected units are not so effective. Integrated approach and teaching of various subjects leads to the better understanding of the content. It provides wholesome knowledge and skill to the students. So, various units of the curriculum must be interrelated at elementary stage. Next is the principle of challenge and enjoyment. Dear students, curriculum of the students of primary school must be challenging, engaging, and motivating. The curriculum should encourage high aspirations and ambitions for all. At primary stage, learners of all aptitudes and abilities should experience an appropriate level of challenge to enable each individual to achieve his potential. They should be active in their learning and have opportunities to develop their creativity, because creativity is very essential for early childhood. There should be support to enable children to sustain their effort. Next is the principle of breadth. Students of primary school students should have opportunities for a broad, suitably weighted. The curriculum should be constructed so that they will learn and develop through a variety of contexts within both the classroom and other aspects of school life. So, this was all about the importance and principles of curriculum development at elementary level. So, now, dear students, let's have a brief view of the principle of curriculum development at elementary level. In this module, we have discussed about the various principles of curriculum development, such as principle of play and activity, child-centered education, variety and flexibility, related with life, related with community, development of democratic needs, logical sequence, local needs, social needs, use of leisure time, principle of correlation, etc. Curriculum construction is a planned activity, which is a systematic process for creating positive improvement in the educational system. During the development of curriculum for primary level students, principle of interrelatedness of the play and work activities must be emphasized. Complete development of individuality is essential. So, all the activities and content should be included in the curriculum, which promote physical, mental, moral, social, and political development of a child. Curriculum should be according to the needs of the students. Changes and continuity are desirable during the curriculum construction. Students should get the totality of experiences according to their age, needs and abilities. Knowledge of culture and civilization is essential for the students of elementary level. Curriculum should help the students to find out suitable solution of the problems and achieve harmonious adjustment with the changing conditions and life situations. Curriculum should fulfill the individual capacities, powers and needs. It should be dynamic and flexible. Various subjects, activities and experiences should promote the social and moral qualities, which are essential for the development of wholesome behavior pattern of the child. Thank you.